Let's learn about apertures. Take a look. Now and now, you just saw the aperture of this lens go from wide open to narrower and then still smaller. Aperture controls the amount of light that makes its way to the digital sensor through the lens. So what's the focal length of your lens? Let's take a look at the example of the most popular kit lens, the 18 to 55mm lens. If we look through the viewfinder, our field of view at 18mm is wider than at 35mm and gets even narrower as we zoom in to 55mm. This is true for any lens. As the value of the focal length increases, that is, as we zoom in, the field of view gets narrower. Just to recap what we learnt in the video titled Setting It, aperture values have the alphabet F written in front of them. To change the aperture value on a digital camera that has just the one tracking wheel, look for the AV button. It's a half-shaded square with a plus and a minus on it. Now turn the tracking wheel while keeping this button pressed and watch the aperture value change. If your camera has two tracking wheels, then the wheel at the back will change the aperture. So let us set our focal length to 18mm and change our aperture to the smallest possible number. Let's see what that is. It happens to be 3.5. Now let's zoom in to 55mm and change the aperture value once again to the smallest possible number. It's no longer 3.5 but 5.6. Now let's zoom back to 18mm. Only this time we are interested in the largest possible aperture value, 22. At 55mm, it does not stop at 22, instead we can go all the way up to 36. Now what does this mean? Remember I showed you different aperture openings on an analog camera? It went from widest to narrower to narrowest. On an 18 to 55mm lens, if you set the aperture value to 3.5, then the lens is at its widest possible aperture opening. At 55mm, the widest possible aperture opening will be at 5.6. Now in between 18 and 55, say 24mm, 35mm, your widest aperture could be 4, 4.5. So let's look at what's written in front of this lens. 18 to 55mm, 1 is to 3.5 to 5.6. 3.5 to 5.6 signifies the range of aperture values, the range of widest possible aperture values. The widest possible aperture value is referred to as the power of the lens. The smaller that number, say 2.8 or 1.8 or 1.4 or 1.2, the better and more expensive the lens. You don't need to memorize these numbers, but you have to be mindful of the widest possible aperture opening at different focal lengths. You can look at what's written on your lens for clues. This concept is true for any zoom lens that has a range of widest possible aperture values. Not all lenses have a range like that. For example, this 16 to 35mm lens opens at 2.8 through the whole range of focal lengths. Lenses that have a fixed widest possible aperture value generally produce better image resolution, are built better, might be weather sealed, and will cost more. So focal length cannot be the only parameter that you stress upon when you're choosing a new lens. You know how to change your ISO sensitivity, shutter speed, and aperture. You also know what they imply. So which one of these would you set first and why? How does aperture impact the photo? We'll talk about all this and more during our next video chat.